corporate presentation, and for this I would like to call on stage. I think she's already on the stage. And please put your hands together for Ms. Varsha Mishra, Deputy Director, NABCB, Quality Council of India. Let's give her a huge round of applause, everyone. Please.
Good afternoon, everybody. I think many of the faces I'm familiar. Yes, hi. So we have in the last meeting also one of the conference where, but here the topic is bit towards packaging. So once again, I'm here telling something about accreditation and how it facilitates trade for the food and business. I think आप उधर से कर देंगे तो better होगा. I'll just say next please. Go back. Yes. This is India ecosystem. Excuse me, can I have a mic in my hand? Give me mic. Give her a minute.
Hello.
I think this is better for me. So, in my presentation, I will give you a brief because today the session and this two-day meet is for the packaging innovation. So my focus would be a QI, that is a quality infrastructure, and where internationally and where nationally we are standing. So let me take you this journey through my presentation. So first of all, you can see in this slide that what our Indian ecosystem is. So quality infrastructure is what? I want this session to be a bit of communicative, so I would request my all the esteemed attendees, so please let me know, do you understand what is a quality infrastructure? Anything, any idea about quality infrastructure? How it is made, what is quality infrastructure, and what is your understanding for quality infrastructure? And what are the points which make quality infrastructure? Because आप सब लोग बहुत ही अपने अपने फील्ड में पारंगत हैं, सबको पता है, बट कहाँ से ये क्वालिटी की बात आती है और कौन सा पैरामीटर है जो तय करता है कि दिस इज अ क्वालिटी? बेसिकली मैं आपको बस बताना चाहूंगी क्योंकि हमारी ही वो लाइन है, क्वालिटी इज बेसिकली मेड ऑफ 3 or 4 एट्रीब्यूट्स, जिसमें कि सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट एट्रीब्यूट यू कैन सी दिस इज अ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वेयर इन यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट इज मेट्रोलॉजिकल. सो मेट्रोलॉजी क्या होती है? मेट्रोलॉजी इज ऑल द SI यूनिट्स, मीटर, सेंटीमीटर, ऑल दिस. सो वी स्टार्ट विद दिस कि आप मेजरमेंट कैसे करते हैं. दैट एट्रीब्यूट इज अ मेट्रोलॉजी, एंड इन इंडिया द इंस्टीट्यूट विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल इज अ नेशनल फिजिकल लेबोरेटरी. देन स्टैंडर्ड बॉडी, स्टैंडर्ड बॉडी कौन सी है हमारी? एनी आइडिया? BIS इज अवर स्टैंडर्ड बॉडी. देन एक्रीडिटेशन, सो वी आर द एक्रीडिटेशन बॉडी. Or just below accreditation, conformity assessment body, which is inspection and validation verification, and then market surveillance, which is the role of regulators. So this whole structure forms the quality infrastructure. Next please. So this is very important slide. Wherever I go and I talk about quality, I ask about this, and I want somebody from you to give me an idea how this works back and forth. Anybody? प्लीज कोई तो बोलिए. आई विल रिपीट क्वेश्चन वंस अगेन. आई वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग हाउ दिस क्वालिटी इन इंटरनेशनल इको सिस्टम इज बिल्ड. हम क्वालिटी क्वालिटी की बात कर रहे हैं, बट क्वालिटी में आप कहाँ पर हैं आप बताइए. एनी बडी वेयर यू स्टैंड एंड हाउ कैन यू गो बैक एंड फोर्थ? एनी बडी? कोई टीचर विचर नहीं, मुझे तो बस पूछना है, मतलब आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू एक अ बेसिक लेमैन, क्योंकि आप एज अ कंज्यूमर भी, आई एम ऑल्सो कंज्यूमर समवेयर, अगर मैं उधर बैठी हूँ आई एम कंज्यूमिंग थिंग्स, बट एज अ कंज्यूमर आप कहाँ पर इस्टेब्लिश कर रहे हैं अपने को और कैसे इंटरनेशनली ये सिस्टम बना हुआ है? वाई वी आर टॉकिंग, एवरीबडी इज टॉकिंग अबाउट क्वालिटी. ओके, सो आप इनमें से कुछ तो यूज़ करते ही हैं ना, और मेरे ख्याल से सब कुछ यूज़ करते हैं. इफ़ यू आर यूजिंग दिस थिंग, देन उसका कहीं ना कहीं सर्टिफिकेशन होता है, उस प्रोडक्ट का कहीं ना कहीं स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन होता है, उसकी टेस्टिंग होती है, इंस्पेक्शन होता है, तब फाइनली वो प्रोडक्ट आपके पास आता है. एंड वंस यू रिसीव योर प्रोडक्ट, देन ऑल्सो अब तो एवरीबडी इज नॉलेजेबल, पीपल सी लेबल पे क्या लिखा हुआ है, क्या खा रहे हैं, क्या पी रहे हैं, क्या पहन रहे हैं, गाड़ी क्या है, AC क्या है, एवरीथिंग. सो सो दैट वे इट कम्स कि जो भी प्रोडक्ट हम कंज्यूम करते हैं ये क्वालिटी का सिस्टम है कि अगर एक्रेडिटेशन है इट मस्ट बी, कोई भी फ्री एक्रेडिटेशन नहीं करेगा, उसकी रिकॉग्निशन इंटरनेशनल बॉडी से होगी, सर्टिफिकेशन मे बी ऑफ डिफरेंट स्टैंडर्ड्स, इसी तरीके से स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन मे बी और इंटरनेशनल एंड नेशनल, बट इट मस्ट बी हार्मोनाइज विद आईसी। ये नहीं कि स्टैंडर्ड बॉडी ने कहा कि मैंने कर दिया इट इज़ डन, नो इट इज़ नॉट डन, इट इज़ बैक एंड फोर्थ प्रोसेस, सिमिलरली टेस्टिंग, इंस्पेक्शन, कैलिब्रेशन, सो दिस इज़ अ इंटरनेशनल इकोसिस्टम ऑफ क्वालिटी। नेक्स्ट प्लीज। Because I am working with the accreditation body, so I will just give you a small detail like what is accreditation. Accreditation is nothing but it is a third party attestation. Next please. And I was talking about the conformity assessment. Do you know what is conformity assessment? Otherwise I will skip because these are the technical terms. Conformity assessment is to check the conformance to the particular specification. अगर आपने कोई एक प्रोडक्ट बनाया है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ बॉटल एंड दिस देयर आर सर्टेन स्पेसिफिकेशन विच इज़ मेड फॉर दिस बॉटल, सो वेदर इट इज़ कम्प्लाइंग विद दोज स्टैंडर्ड दैट इज़ कॉल्ड इट इज़ कन्फर्मिंग टू द पर्टिकुलर स्टैंडर्ड, और जो इसको चेक करता है दीज बॉडीज आर कॉल्ड एज अ कन्फर्मिटी असेसमेंट बॉडीज, सो दिस इज बेसिकली अ मॉडल टू अश्योर कम्प्लायंस। नेक्स्ट प्लीज। Here you can see the role. If in the whole chain, this is a food chain, you can see there is supply, there are manufacturers, distributors, retailers, but standard applies to everybody. Like supplier inspection will apply. If they are manufacturer, then certification as per 17021 applies. If they are distributor, then certification as per 17021 or 20 applies. If they are retailer, then testing is applicable. So different standards. So this is a system which will support the food supply chain through accreditation. Next please. So in India we have FSSAI as a regulator, so they have regulation, they have a licensing and registration regulation, they have a food product standards, and here they have specifically food labeling and packaging standard also, which always we consider when we talk about the conformity assessment. Next please. So how in India we ensure the food safety? It is through BIS which make the standard, then EIC which is an advisory body to the central government and which is basically for the notified commodities which is notified under Act, and these are the basically primary or testified food. Then APIDA which is basically for the NPOP organic. Next please. Next. Because I am just skipping those slides which is time taking and not of much relevance here. And this is about something in food safety and standard packaging regulation of 2018 of FSSAI. This is applicable to all pre-packaged food, which means food placed in a package of any nature in such a manner that the content cannot be changed without tampering and which is ready to sale, ready for the sale to the final consumer. So this is the packaging regulation which is made by FSSAI, and anybody and everybody in India who is importing have to follow this regulation. So you can see these draft regulations are also made for packaging, which is to keep the consumer product safe. Next please. So why these food safety standards are required? So you can see the boxes one by one, they serve as a benchmarking, they common language for communicating the buyer's requirement to its suppliers, common language for taking actions, establishing the criteria which should meet to protect consumers and establish confidence in the product. Next. And I spoke about standards. So packaging, because you people are doing innovations, but innovations also have some limits. How much innovation you will do? So this somewhere, the food standard somewhere give you the way. Whatever you do, whatever the innovation, the first thing it should be for the safe food. Consumables, whatever you are eating, it should be in the way you are making and your intent to supply to your consumers. So food safety standards, you can see more than 1600 standards are there, out of which these all standards talks about food. So in ISO 22000 series, these all standards are pertaining to food. But ISO TS 22002-4, it specifically talks about food packaging manufacturing. So you can go through it whenever you have time, why we are talking about quality, which standard are linked with the packaging material. Next. Similarly, ISO 22, as I told you earlier in previous slide, this ISO 22002 is basically for the food packaging, and you can see there are some prerequisite programs on food safety which specifically mentioned this defines this specific requirement of establishing, implementing and maintaining prerequisite programs to assist in controlling food safety hazard in the manufacture of the food packaging. So whenever anybody, any audit is going to take place or certification is going to be there, always they ask about these questions. No matter what way you are maintaining in your plant or you are interacting, but these are the basic reference term they are using for the standard which is applicable for the food packaging. Next. Similarly, this is one more standard. I think many of you might be aware, those who are exporting product across the globe, this is FSSC standard, FSSC 20,000, which also talks about packaging material, because it is applicable not only the food but also across all the organizations that manufacture primary and secondary food and feed packaging and or intermediate component. Because somebody in my panel also talks about intermediate and intermittent packaging. So this is also one of the standard which talks about packaging, and they don't only talk about final food product, but they talk about retail and wholesale, different categories are mentioned. So this is also one standard which talks about packaging standard. Next. BIS is a standard body. I have already defined and informed you in the my second PPT slide. So this is standard, like IS 9845 is for determining the overall migration of constituent. So you know the safe food, food contact material, this all terms are referred to the packaging innovation. So you can also see not only standard talks about packaging, but also FSMS, BIS standard body, and even the regulators have defined all these terms in the regulations. Next please. So these are the different international organizations through different measures. Their basic purpose is food security, safety, but through different level of innovation, no matter it is packaging, no matter it is safety produce, or no matter it is a feed or ingredient about. So you can see these are the different international organizations which is linked, and they have a specific requirement for the packaging even. Next. And as I told you, we are talking about sustainability and all this. So these are the 17 different, out of which 17, there are 11 different SDGs which is pertaining to the health and food safety. Next please. You can see these are all linked. And being an accreditation body, we are the member of ILAC and IAF. And why I am talking about IAF and ILAC, because accreditation is something which is voluntary, but the purpose becomes mandate when it is being mandated by the government or regulators. So the main purpose is tested and inspected or certified once and accepted everywhere. Next. This is about QCI where I work. So we are the part of Ministry of Commerce and Industry and specific department DPIIT, that is Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. Our mandate you can see on the slide, and our chairman is appointed by Honorable Prime Minister of India. Next. This is our structure. We have four accreditation board, NABL and NABCD, we are the part of that accreditation body. NABH is for hospital, NABET is for education institute, then quality promotion is NBQP. Yesterday I was in Guwahati where we have conducted Assam Gunvatta Sankalp. So therein we are doing for every class, so we are working for Sarpanch Samvad, that is something QCI is doing. So NBQP is the work of that quality promotion. Then we have a different special project group wherein we assist government departments for different project planning. Next. This is our certificate, you can say how many we have issued in certification and accreditation. Next. These are the steps of accreditation, how your certification body can be accredited. So I have shown the steps, like you have to submit application, scheme review will happen, then secretariat review will happen, then team appointment, then document review, reassessment if required, office assessment, witness assessment. So any of the CB or IB, if they want to get accreditation, they have to follow this procedure. After that, they will be accredited under NABCB. Next. This is our international equivalence where we stand. So we are in APEC, that is Asia Pacific Accreditation Cooperation, because we are into Asian continent. Next. This is international recognition. So we are here. we are here, and any of the AB which is in Europe, they will be here. Any of the Americas AB, it will be here, because we are in Asia continent, so our place is here. Next. It is almost similar. Next, please. This is our accreditation framework. So ऐसा नहीं है कि हम accreditation body है, हमें भी कोई नहीं check करता है. Every 4 years we are audited and we are peerly evaluated by ASEC countries. Like they come to us, they affect whatever the scope we have, they evaluate us. And accreditation body, they evaluate conformity assessment bodies based on international standard. Similarly, the certification and inspection body, they assess the product and service providers, means clients or exporters. Next, please. Next. So these are the different scheme owners. They talk about the packaging. They have different clause through which they talk about packaging. So you can refer FSSC 20,000, Global Gap, BRCGS. Next. Next. So this is our outreach and international presence. So we are across with the different international bodies. Next. So ultimately, this would be, I think, second last slide. Why I am talking about accreditation? This is the tool which never asks you to come to us for the accreditation, but we definitely give you a space wherein the thing which you are already doing for through certification or inspection, but once you are doing the same thing with the accredited CB or inspection body, your equivalency is across the globe. So that is the purpose about this, and the benefits of this you can see here. You can see more of the case studies in the sites which is mentioned here. Next, please. Benefits of accreditation, I think I have brochures with me, so I'll keep outside. You can, anybody of you interested, you can take the brochure from the outside. Next, please. These are the government regulators and industry who rely on us, and almost every ministry has prescribed accredited conformity assessment bodies. So through that we are mandated. Otherwise, you can see commerce industry, they have mentioned specifically NABCB accredited certification and inspection bodies, third party inspection. So we are not voluntary, but through their this regulation we become mandatory. So you can see even FSSAI, their regulation, so we are everywhere. Next, please. And this is something proud. I told earlier also, like we were on the 10th place earlier, but now in last GQI we are on the 5th place in India. Now Indian Accreditation Forum is on the 5th place, so it is actually a proud moment for us. Next, please. This is video. I don't think we have time. You will not permit me. We don't have. Otherwise, I can play next. In the tea break, you can play if you wish.
Sure.
Okay. Thank you very much for hearing me, and thank you for all the patience. Any questions you have, I have still time. I can take question. In the meantime, I will run the video. Please run the video, IT team, please. Anybody, any questions, please? Please.
जी बताइए.
आपके लेजी पेपर बहुत सारे बड़े थे.
Thank you, ma'am. Very wonderful session.
Thank you.
We have discussed a lot of things regarding this innovative packaging and packaging. Development in different sectors, smart packaging, all. But my question is, there's lot of use part is in unorganized. There is a two sectors in food industry in India currently. There is a organized sector and another is unorganized sector. Definitely is a use unorganized sector in India. And good thing is they are also using packaging, they are selling in their product in packaging form. But my question is to you, that what regulators, what QCI has think about this enforcement, regulatory implementation in that sector, because of lot of food is being packaged in this packaging material, which is a lot of food additives being used, so there is no quality checks in India. What पैकिंग मटेरियल इज सप्लायर प्रोवाइडिंग एंड दिस मैन्युफैक्चरर इज पैकिंग इन दैट फूड इन दैट विच इज डायरेक्टली कॉन्टेक्ट इन पैकिंग मटेरियल देर इज नो क्वालिटी चेक्स देर इज नो माइग्रेशन टेस्ट सो वट नेक्स्ट FSSAI एंड रेगुलेटरी बॉडी इज थिंकिंग अबाउट दिस
आपका क्वेश्चन तो बहुत ब्रॉड है और जो कि दोनों चीज़ों को दिखा रहा है बट आई विल टेल यू वन थिंग FSSAI ने अनऑर्गनाइज और ऑर्गेनाइज दोनों के लिए एक सिस्टम बना रखा हुआ है बिकॉज दे डिफाइन बेस्ड ऑन द टर्न ओवर स्मॉल ऑल्सो बिग ऑल्सो और आप जो कह रहे हैं कि सिस्टम नहीं है चेक का सारे सिस्टम तो उसी लिए बने हुए हैं बट द पॉइंट इज़ कि हाउ मच यू डिक्लेयर सिस्टम इज़ देयर इवन आप FCM की बात करेंगे फूड कॉन्टैक्ट मटेरियल की बात करेंगे पैकेजिंग इनोवेशन की बात करेंगे जो मैंने आपको फूड एंड पैकेजिंग का दिखाया है रेगुलेशन इफ़ यू गो थ्रू दैट रेगुलेशन ना इट टॉक्स अबाउट सिंगल पिटी थिंग वॉट अ FBO हैज़ टू डू नो मैटर बट वॉट यू हैव टू सी लाइक आप ठेले वाले हैं लाइक ठेले वाले का भी उन्होंने एक लाइसेंसिंग तो वो तभी दे रहे हैं जब वो आपका रेगुलर चेक कर रहे हैं अब लाइसेंस के बियॉन्ड कोई कुछ कर रहा है तो देखिए उसके लिए तो हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते बट अगर जो आप बता रहे हैं ना कि अनऑर्गनाइज है यस अनऑर्गनाइज है हमारे इंडिया में अनऑर्गनाइज ज़्यादा है फॉर एग्जांपल द न्यू फूड सेक्टर्स लाइक वीगन ले लीजिए वीगन में कोई बड़ा बहुत स्टेक प्लेयर नहीं है बिकॉज अब बड़े अलग अलग तरीके के रिटेलर्स पैकर्स सब चीज़ें चल गई हैं बट ऐसा नहीं है फूड पैकेजिंग रेगुलेशन फूड स्टैंडर्ड दे स्पेसिफिकली टॉक अबाउट द टाइम चेक सैम्पल कलेक्शन मार्केट सर्वेलेंस एंड दे डू सैम्पल टेस्टिंग आपने ये बात की मुझे अच्छा लगा बट नॉर्मली पीपल आर फेड अप विद द टेस्टिंग एंड आप आते हैं आपके इंस्पेक्टर सैंपल इतने टेस्ट करते हैं बट आप कह रहे नहीं करते हैं बहुत करते हैं
एक्चुअली मैम वीगन इज नॉट इन अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर का नहीं है
यू आर करेक्ट यू आर टेकिंग आई एम टेकिंग एग्जांपल बिकॉज आज वीगन आपको लग रहा है बिकॉज इंडिया इज द फर्स्ट कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड वेयर द वीगन स्टैंडर्ड हैज बीन मेड एंड आई एम द पर्सन हु इज इन दैट टीम ऑल्सो in that committee so vegan is just one example I said but normally it happened because agar regulation banaya food packaging ka uske andar frequency likhi hui hai aur frequency ke sath agar aap section 4 dekhenge na unka to sab kuch define hai cleaning sanitation ab aap ye kahenge to main isko kaise bolungi mujhe nahi pata lekin there are checks
actually drafting has been done I know that FSSAI has done lot of things to draft बट एक्चुअली ऑन ऑन ग्राउंड
पैकेजिंग में है ये मत बोलिए एवरीवेयर अभी मैंने आपको FSMS की बात करी है आप तो क्लॉज 2.9 स्पेसिफिकली टॉक्स अबाउट पैकेजिंग और जब हम जाते हैं तो सैंपल कलेक्ट होता है तो हम पैकेजिंग का भी एक सैंपल उठाते हैं एंड वी स्पेसिफिकली चेक द पैकेजिंग रूम आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑल द ऑफिस कहीं ना कहीं अब दिस इज नॉट द फोरम
लॉट ऑफ गैप्स आई थिंक
All right. So, thank you so much, ma'am, for giving us so much of information and knowledge.
If there is any question, please, I love to give replies. Anybody? Thank you so much. Thank you for hearing.
Okay. So, to felicitate Ms. Varsha Mishra, I would like to call on stage. Please put your hands together for Mr. K. Ravi, Managing Director from Rovema India. Let's give him a huge round of applause.